Not sure if you know this, but when we first met, I got so nervous, I couldn't speak. In that very moment, I found the one and my life had found its missing piece. So as long as I live for love, you will have it hold you. You look so beautiful in white, and from now to my very last breath, this day I'll cherish. You look so beautiful in white tonight. Is timeless, my love is endless, and with this ring I say to the world, you're my every reason, you're all that I believe in. With all my heart I mean every word.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Also with you.
Good afternoon, and welcome to St. Justin's Church for this beautiful occasion. of the wedding of Kelly and Brian. We welcome all the Muscogeeries and all the Lynches and all their family and friends to this joyous occasion. Brothers and sisters, we gather in this church of St. Justin the Martyr to give praise and thanks to Almighty God for his many gifts. God created all things to show forth his love and made the human person the high point of his creation. In the fullness of time, God's love became flesh in the person of Jesus Christ, who showed us the depth of God's love by living and loving and by dying and rising. Today, God's love will become flesh again in the love of Kelly and Brian. So let us ask the Lord to bless them and the marriage that they enter into today. Let us pause for silence. Now, the one thing we do differently than at a regular Mass is at this point we will exchange peace so everybody is calm and relaxed. Let us exchange with one another a sign of God's peace. Thank you. Let us pray. O God, who in creating the human race willed that husband and wife should be one, join, we pray, in the bond of inseparable love. Brian and Kelly, your servants who are to be united in the covenant of marriage, so that as you make their love fruitful, they may become by your grace witnesses to charity itself. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated as Brian's cousin Anthony will read our first reading today from the book of Genesis.
The Lord God said, "It is not good for the man to be alone. I will make him a suitable partner for him." So the Lord God formed out the ground various wild animals and various birds of the air, and he brought them to the man to see what he would call them. Whatever the man called each of them would be its name. The man gave names to all the cattle, all the birds of the air, and all the wild animals, but none proved to be the suitable partner for the man. So the Lord God cast a deep sleep on the man, and while he was asleep, he took out one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. The Lord God then built up into the woman the rib that he had taken from the man. When he brought her to the man said, "This one at last is my bone of my bones, and flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called woman, for out of her man this one has been taken. This is why a man leaves his father and mother and clings to his wife, and the two of them become one body." The word of the Lord.
Our responsorial psalm is printed in your program. It is loving and forgiving.
Thank you.
Kelly's godmother and aunt Donna offer our second reading from St. Paul's letter to the Corinthians.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, strive eagerly for the greatest spiritual gifts, but I shall show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but do not have love, I am not responding God or a pleasure symbol. And if I have the gift of prophecy and comprehend all mysteries and all knowledge, if I have all faith so as to move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away everything I own, and if I hand my body over so that I will lose, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient, love is kind. It is not jealous, it is not pompous. It is not inflated, it is not rude. It does not seek its own interest. It is not quick-tempered, it does not brood over injury. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
For those who were not here last night, I said that this is the time for the homily, and what I do with the homily, I take Brian's age, I take Kelly's age, I'll add that, I'll multiply it by two, and that's how many minutes I'll be speaking for the homily, because you have no place to go today, right? So you can stay here with us. Are you two ready? Did you prepare those questions that I asked you? Did you prepare that speech I asked you, poem that I asked you to recite?
Yep.
No, I didn't ask any of that. What I usually do is I give the couple to be married some advice that I have gleaned through priesthood and mostly through talking to married couples who have been married for many years. They often give me very good advice, sometimes humorous advice. I had a couple that was married for 70 years, and I came and I gave them a blessing at Mass, and I asked them, I said, what's the secret to being married for 70 years? to which the husband was wearing a hearing aid. He said, "Father, I just turned this off." Another one said to me once that what I've learned that after 3 months of marriage to keep my mouth shut. But all right, the advice that I always give. There are so many things that you are going to need in your marriage. And I've listed like four of them. And then I'm going to read some of the comments that you gave because you gave me the same things, okay? But the first thing that every marriage that has endured for many years, people tell me, would be faith in God. Having that strong faith, because we know that our world is a changing world. The world that I grew up in and your parents grew up in is much different than the world that you will or Mateo will grow up in. It's a different world, and we need faith. We need God. We need values. We need these morals. So you need to invite Christ into this marriage. It's the two of you and Christ, and that will be something that will hold you through the storms. Talking to any married couple, believe it or not, you might have an argument one day if you already haven't. And getting through this, that's okay, that's human nature. As long as at the end of the day, we tell each other we love them, that we are there with them. So faith is the most important thing. I always say family. I'm gonna read what you two have read because you two have your priorities in the right place. You don't mind? What I always do with my couples preparing them for marriage, I ask them to do a little homework assignment for me, and I ask them questions. Now I'm gonna read what Kelly has said, about Brian, and then Brian, would you want me to do his first? Or
it doesn't matter.
That doesn't matter, okay.
Surprise.
Brian is the love of my life, my soulmate, my best friend, he has to be, my rock, my teacher, your teachers of each other, my supporter, my problem solver, my Mr. Fix-It. So Brian, when things are broken, get those tools ready. My comedian, my therapist, my everything. He is the perfect gentleman and so selfless. Because marriage calls us to give and give and give. So we must be selfless, not thinking of ourselves, but thinking of the other. Not only am I head over heels for Brian, my whole family is as well. Is that true, Margaret and Rich? All right. which is good, family. People tell me, well, I'm not marrying his family, I'm marrying him, or I'm not marrying her family, I'm marrying her. You marry into families. Get used to that. It is so special that we are all so close and get along so well, because family is the most important thing to both of us. Important. Great. And that would be my second thing, family. I know he is going to be a great husband, but I think what makes me even happier is knowing that one day, if we are fortunate enough, that he will be an even better father to our children. The best way for a husband to love his wife is to love the children, and vice versa. Brian makes me want to be a better person, and I want to make Brian happy as he strives and succeeds to make me every day. I thank God, important, every day for Brian and the love that we share. Marriage to me is a lifelong commitment, as it should to all. It's a sacrament, it's a covenant. Different than a contract, I do the work, you pay me, and it's finished. A covenant lasts for a lifetime. We swear our lives to each other in a covenant. Beautiful. It is a celebration and a promise of the couple's unconditional love that they have for each other in front of God and all their family and closest friends. God is so critical. Being married is having that one person you can count on no matter what to always be by your side through the good, the bad, and all that is in between. It's about growing and compromising with each other. It's about giving and sharing your life with another person. It's not just one now, it's two. Two become one. Now, Brian, you ready?
Sure.
All right. We have a lot of the same core qualities and morals. Morals, as I said, is critical in this day and age, in our time. But we compliment each other in that she is very sweet and thoughtful. Well, that might sound that you're not. All right, but I'm a little bit more tough and calculated. It occasionally leads to disagreements, and they will come, but I think it also makes us a great team. We both love and respect our families deeply. So see how they both realize the importance of family. Your blessed parents, Brian's four grandparents are here. We welcome everybody. So Rosanna and Anthony, Margaret and Rich, and all the family, Lauren, Joseph, Shannon, all your family and friends that are here today. All right, my favorite thing about Kelly is her kindness. She always wants to do the right thing and doesn't have a mean bone in her body. It was very important to me to find someone who had similar family values that I was raised on. That's a blessing to you. God bless you. It is a blessing that our families get along as well as they do. Well, especially you have the Italian family, the Irish family, so it's the Gaelic and the garlic coming together in this wedding. Kelly and I purchased, now this is interesting, and this is where the fights come. Kelly and I purchased a townhouse together recently, and we are looking forward to being married and just being able to live and build together. Between purchasing a place and planning a wedding, we have been through some trying times in our relationship. It has helped us through, though, in understanding how to compromise with each other and with our families. You mean they were involved with this too? But compromise is critical also. I know that I am not perfect, none of us are, but she loves me with all of my flaws and we want to make each other better people. We just can't wait to get through these next 3 weeks of craziness and get back to what truly matters to both of us, just being together and starting a strong family. Brian and Kelly, you have come together to this church of St. Justin the Martyr so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love. I stand here between you and this gathering of God's people, the church, to witness your vows, along with your chosen witnesses, Shannon, Jennifer, and Joseph. Where there is love, there is Christ, who abundantly blesses your love. Through your baptism, Christ made you his adopted children and members of his priestly people. He now enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament, so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. And so in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. Have you come here freely to this church of St. Justin so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love?
Yes.
Do you promise to be faithful to each other, and that will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church?
Yes.
Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, I now ask you to join your right hands and declare your consent before God and his holy church. Brian, repeat after me.
I, Brian, take you, Kelly.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you and honor you.
I will love you and honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
Now, Kelly, your turn. I, Kelly, take you, Brian.
I, Kelly, take you, Brian.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you and honor you.
I will love you and honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
Brian, Kelly, you have declared your consent before the church. May the Lord in his goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with his blessings. What God has joined must not be divided. Now the blessing of the rings, if Joseph did his part.
He hasn't taken his hands out of his pockets.
Thank you.
with children, a warm love reaching out to others, and good health until a ripe old age. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick, lonely, discouraged, or oppressed, that they may be strengthened by God's help and aided by their friends, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For these personal needs, which we mention now in silence, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, we ask you to hear our prayers, especially for Kelly and Brian as they begin their married life together. We ask you to grant all the things we need in our lives and to give us the grace to accept your will. We ask this in all things through Christ our Lord. Amen. One of the beautiful things that both Kelly and Brian did was included their godparents. Kelly's godmother, Red, and now they will ask Brian's godmother, Josephina, and Kelly's godfather, Robert, will bring up the gifts, which are on the back table. Carol will escort you up. So, if everybody be seated as our altar is prepared and our gifts are brought up. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, and Eternal God. For you have forged the covenant of marriage as a sweet yoke of harmony and an unbreakable bond of peace, so that the chaste and fruitful love of holy matrimony may serve to increase the children you adopt as your own. By your providence and grace, O Lord, you accomplish the wonder of this twofold design, that while the birth of children brings beauty to the world, their rebirth and baptism gives increase to the church through Christ our Lord. Through him, the angels and all the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. By sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and David, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Strengthen, we pray, in the grace of marriage, Kelly and Brian, whom you have brought happily to their wedding day, that under your protection they may always be faithful in their lives to the covenant they have sealed in your presence. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, glorious martyrs, Saint Justin, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever." If we're ready to change the sign of peace, so we'll just go into the breaking of the bread.
We
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. This point will have Holy Communion. For those first, I'll give communion and the precious blood to Brian and to Kelly and to Shannon and Jan and Joseph. And then Carol and I will distribute communion. If you are not Catholic or you're not properly disposed and you're not receiving communion today, but if you'd like a blessing, if you come to me and hold your hands across your chest like this, I'll extend the blessing of the church to you. But first, Carol and I will give the body and blood to Brian, Kelly, and Shannon, and Jen, and Jessica.
Now the reception, I'm sure the DJ is going to say for the first time, Mrs. and Mrs. Montgomery.
Well,
they don't get it right either.
Sure.
But this is the first time because what they are married now in the church and in the eyes of God and in the state. So I, before the final blessings, there's a nuptial blessing, which is an old traditional blessing of the church. I'll, you know, bless over the two of you. And then the final blessing, and then we go forth and celebrate this great day. Well, I congratulate you both. It's been great working with you. I enjoyed it. You're so organized. I love that. All right. Yeah, congratulations. Congratulations. Now, Carol, you want to hold for me? As I said, today's celebration will end with two blessings. The first blessing is for Brian and Kelly. Since it is the church's nuptial blessing, I invite all the baptized members of the church to join me in imparting this special prayer by extending your right hand in a gesture of blessing as I pronounce the nuptial blessing on Brian and Kelly. And afterward will be the final blessing for all present. Kelly and Brian, please bow your heads as we pray first in silence for the Lord to bless you and the marriage you have entered into. Now hold your hands high, your heads high for the nuptial blessing. Father, by your power, you have made everything out of nothing. In the beginning, you created the universe and made us in your own likeness. You gave man the constant help of woman so that man and woman should no longer be two, but one flesh. And you teach us that what you have united may never be divided. Father, by your plan, man and woman are united, and married life has been established. As the one blessing that was not forfeited by original sin or washed away in the flood of Noah's time. Look with love upon Kelly, your daughter, now joined to Brian, her husband, in marriage. She asks for your blessing. Give her the grace of your love and peace. May she always follow the example of the holy woman whose praises are sung in the scriptures. May her husband, Brian, put his trust in her and recognize that she is his equal and the heir with him to the life of grace. May he always honor her and love her as Christ loves his bride, the church. Father, keep them always true to your commandments. Keep them faithful in marriage, and let them be living examples of Christian life. Give them the strength that comes from the gospel, so that they may be witnesses of Christ to others and all they meet. Bless them with children, and help them to be good parents. May they live to see their children's children, and after a happy old age, grant them fullness of life with the saints in the kingdom of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you all. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your lives. Congratulations once again.
Don't be afraid, I have loved you.
clap your hands to the beat. For the rest of the VIP section, come on, party, which is a major mother and best man, also my sister and Bruce's brother. Give it up nice and loud for Shannon and Joseph! Everybody clap your hands, just go, go! Oh yeah, here we go, go! And right now, this time I introduce you to the two people whose love and matrimony we're celebrating here today. This song is a beautiful song. I love to first. So once again, put those hands together nice and loud for me.
Look at the two of you dancing that way, lost in the moment, each other's face. So much love, you're alone in this place. Like there's nobody else in the world. I was enough for her not long ago. I was her number one. She told me so, and she still means.
So once again, ladies and gentlemen, let's give him a great big round of applause. Put those hands together. All right, ladies and gentlemen, right now we do ask everyone to please return to your seats as we prepare for our champagne.
Spirit. God our Father, Lord of all creation, we gather now to celebrate the love and commitment of Kelly and Brian as they share their first meal together as husband and wife. We thank you for giving your holy blessing today upon their marriage and ask that you continue to bless them with your love and mercy throughout their lives together. Let this be the first of many loving meals shared together with our family and friends and blessed by your amazing grace. And with Kelly and Brian, as we are their family, friends, and loved ones gathered here in your presence, we ask for holy blessing upon this meal together as we say, bless us, O Lord, and these thy gifts, which we're about to receive from thy bounty through Christ our Lord. Amen. All right. Kelly, you are my twin sister, my heart and soul, and my best friend. I remember being little girls playing with our Barbie dolls, then as we grew older making your dream wedding scrapbook. We have dreamed of this day forever, and I am so proud and blessed to be part of your wedding. I wish you and Brian a lifelong journey of happiness and love together.
Sorry, I'm not as short and sweet as Shannon. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you all for coming here to celebrate Kelly and Brian. For those of you I have not met yet, I'm Jennifer, Kelly's older cousin, and would like to thank Kelly and Brian for letting me be part of such a special day and was so honored when Kelly asked me to be her maid of honor. I have known Kelly literally since the day she was born. Both of our families lived in Tom's River, so I was fortunate to spend a lot of time growing up and watching Kelly grow. As a baby, Kelly's favorite things to do were laugh, eat, and sleep, and those of you who know her well, those are still her favorite things to do. I'm the youngest in my family, but because Kelly is 6 years younger, I was granted with the honor of being more like a big sister than a cousin. I got to attend all the milestones in Kelly's life, and must say I am so proud of the person you've become. Kelly, I admire so much that you are true to yourself and do not care what others think. You clearly display this since you're one of the only girls in high school I know that was obsessed with Cher. You always put others first and have such a caring nature. I cannot begin to tell you how proud I was of you when you pursued your dreams, moved to New York City to attend PACE not knowing anyone or anything in that area, but still managed to fully succeed even beyond your expectations. Now we come to my favorite time since I've known Kelly. It was the summer and she was 21 and I was 26 and we were sitting by the lounge chairs in my parents' backyard by the pool, which is our absolute favorite thing to do. We were talking about dating, what's the best mascara, the best place to go out, all the important things in life. And it was that day I realized you were no longer my little cousin. You had grown into one of my best friends and have been ever since that day. Now, Brian. Brian, I truly cannot remember what it was like to not have you in Kelly's life because you've just been in so naturally since the first day I met you. I always hoped for Kelly to wind up with an amazing, caring, smart, and generous person, and you've exceeded any expectation that anyone has ever had. I'm so happy to have you become part of our family and know that Kelly will find all the happiness in the world with you. So I'd like to close with my thoughts on Kelly and Brian as a couple. When I see the two of you together, the words nurturing and comfortable come to mind. You nurture each other to grow in your relationship and also as individuals to be true to yourself. You're completely at ease and honest with each other and find comfort in each other's company. I think this makes a lot of sense because as we all go through life, there's one thing we all say. There's no place like home because of the comforting and nurturing environment that we all find there. When you two found each other, your hearts came home to where they belong. Please raise your glass and congratulate Kelly and Brian.
Let's hear it for the ladies, everybody. Let's hear a great, great round of applause. And right now, we're about to hand the microphone to the very best man of the evening, besides Brian, of course. Besides Brian, and that means his brother. Make some noise for Joseph!
Yeah!
Come on!
You want to say it, Joe?
To start off, I'd like to thank all you guys for coming out. It means a lot to Brian and Kelly, as well as all of us, to be here Richard, Margaret, and my parents, Tony and Rosanna, for helping put all this together. Without them, this couldn't have been possible. So, again, I'd like to personally welcome Kelly to our family. I look forward to having her as a sister. I remember the first time that I actually met Kelly, we all went out for a couple of drinks after work one night. And up until that point, I haven't really heard much about her, except when my brother was telling me about this cute girl I used to work with. And finally, when I got to meet her, my first impressions were a little skeptical. Yeah, she was pretty, but she was also pretty drunk. I think I only said like four words to her. Hi, I'm Brian's brother. But I could tell my brother and her were really both into each other, and they seemed to really hit it off. From that point, they never looked back. I mean, Kelly even stuck around after my brother lost all his hair. Yeah, believe it or not, he had hair. Getting the chance to be around them and getting to know Kelly better, they just seemed to have a really great connection and seemed to complement each other very well. And one of the biggest things that stood out to me was how much Kelly really cared and loved my brother. It's kind of weird that my big brother is getting married. It seems like just yesterday, we were out back playing catch, we were sneaking inside the house so I wouldn't get caught drinking at a party. But at the same time, I couldn't see him be with anyone else or finding anyone better. As the old saying goes, marriage isn't about finding someone you care, you can live with. It's about finding someone you can't live without. I think Brian and Kelly found that in each other, and I wish them the best.